I step into war today with an abiding faith in America.
You will lead those state troopers.
And under those that they have faith in the future of mankind.
You will do something that will transform conditions here in Alabama. So I'm not worried this afternoon, however dark it may be, however difficult it may be. I know that it is true, the truth forever on the scaffold, wrong forever on the throne.
Yes, sir.
That is another part of that great statement. Yet that scaffold sways the future. Behind the dim unknown standeth God within the shadows, keeping watch above his own. William Cullen Bryant is right. Truth fresh to earth will rise again. The Bible is right. You shall reap what you sow.
The past several years, it has become clear that the technique of mass nonviolent direct action has not only become the accepted method of the civil rights movement, but beyond that, the vast majority of all Americans now support and approve what began as a limited expression of protest 10 years ago in Montgomery, Alabama, to integrate a bus line. It's grown into a national phenomenon. History has become a nation of order. America must not remain silent. Not merely black America, but all of America. It must speak up and act, from the president down to the humblest of us, not for the sake of the Negro, but for the sake of the image, the idea, and the aspiration of America itself. One day, a year later, a lady by the name of Rosa Parks decided that she wasn't going to take it any longer. She stayed on a bus trip. You may not remember it because it's way back now, several years, but it was the beginning of a movement. Yet the truth is that no one can scorn the nonviolent direct action or civil disobedience without canceling out American history. The first nonviolent direct action did not occur in Montgomery. Its roots go back to the American. As Albert Einstein right when he said, the world is in greater peril from those who tolerate evil than from those who actively commit it. Not President Kennedy warned that those who do nothing are inviting shame as well. The movement has, in a few years, changed the total description of American youth. From the silent generation, they have become the morally and socially concerned generation.
Because I've been to the mountains now.
I have a dream
that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold the